You can't make a difference until you make a decision. Ah! I was growing up, it was a long, long time ago, but when we used to fight, we used to get in a circle, and then two people would get in the middle, and then you'd fight. And I got smart, because I ain't really like to fight, so I got smart. And I started telling guys who said they wanted to fight me, I'd say, look, let's do this. Let's not fight in front of nobody. If you really want to fight, let's go in the back, just me and you. Like, I don't know why you clowning in front of everybody, why you gotta try to be the big man. Let's just, me and you, go to the back, and let's just fight, and don't nobody get, if you really want to fight. And I learned, E.T., if you want to get out of fights in the D, the more you run, the more they gonna want to fight you. So I'm telling you, in life, you start running from a class, you start running from a subject that you don't like, it will haunt you for the rest of your natural life. It ain't going nowhere. I need you to be honest, do an honest assessment. I want you to write down what it is you're trying to do, and I need you to be very honest about where you are in terms of what you're trying to do. Like, where are you? So for those of you who, like, I want to be a millionaire, I just need you to really be, like, think through, where are you financially? Like, in terms of financial literacy, where are you? In terms of financial discipline, where are you? And in your past, where are you? Do you spend money you don't have?
How success comes with struggle. If you start running from something in life, it will haunt you. Face things head on. If you approach the challenge, you have a better chance of winning. Be honest about your goals and hold your own weight. How can you fuel your dreams? Do you have enough fuel? Encourage yourself to wake up earlier and seize the day. Eric Thomas started waking up at 3 a.m. to finish college classes. He says he didn't handle his business, so he had to discipline himself and wake up earlier to succeed. Eric Thomas doesn't believe in procrastination. Some things are not important or meaningful or urgent to you. When something isn't meaningful, you will put it off. How can you make parts of your life stick? When you want to succeed as much as you want to breathe, you will be successful. A common challenge across the board is that people don't believe.
I start getting up at 3 o'clock in the morning. It's like, yo, you're gonna have to get up a little bit earlier because you didn't finish school. You didn't take care of your business. So you can't get up the same time another man who gets up who handle his business. So you need to get up at 3 if you're gonna catch the greats. You gotta get up at 3, you gotta go to bed earlier. This is why I said I never drank or smoked, because the men in my life who did it were extremists. I had an uncle who died, cirrhosis of the liver. You know, I had other uncles who drank, and my father, bless his heart, but he was strung out on drugs for about 14 years. And I was just like, yo, E, you can see that they don't know how to do it casually. Like, they ain't social drinkers. Like, they ain't social on something. They taking it to a whole other level. And so for me, it was like, E, you got to discipline yourself. You're not going to die if you never know what alcohol tastes like. But if you taste it, you might have the same experience they had. So you just got to discipline yourself. You know, I do vegan most of the time. You know what I'm saying? And I tell people all the time, I love fried chicken. I love macaroni and cheese. I love a lot of dessert. But in my family is diabetes. So it's like, yo, E, if you do what they do, then you're gonna get the results they got.
I don't believe in the word procrastination. Like, I don't really believe in that word. I told a young lady in Australia who told me she was a procrastinator. I said, look, if I told you to meet me here tomorrow at 5 a.m. and I'm gonna give you $3 million, where would you be? She said, I'll be right there at 4:59, ready to get that $3 million. And I said, so then there's no such thing as procrastination. What it is it's not important to you, right? It's not meaningful to you. It's not something that's urgent to you. And when something is not urgent, you put it off. So yep, you're in school, yes. You probably are getting grades, etc. But if it's not meaningful to you, if it's not important to you, then you're not going to make it a priority. So what you have to do is find out, how can you make it meaningful? How can you make it purposeful? How can you make it stick? And when you can find that out, I promise you, you'll get up early, you'll get there first, and you'll do whatever it takes to make that goal a reality. So for me, no such thing as procrastination. It's a such thing as it's not a priority to you.
For me, when I went to school, I'll just be real cute. Somebody dropped me off, mom, say, you're gonna love it, I never loved it. Like, I never even knew where I was going, other than I knew it was illegal to drop out too early, you know? So the book for me is going back to that 13-year-old who found out his father wasn't his biological father. And all of the emotional, you know, and mental stuff that I was going through, and I was too young to process it on my own, and I ended up making some terrible decisions based on it. So this book was written for that 13-year-old when he found out it's not your real father. Like, this book was like, yo, somebody should have told me this. You know, somebody should have told me what my strengths were and what my limitations were, because I didn't even know, being a people person, how that would devastate me. Being that I needed affirmation and that I, you know, needed to, like, almost be clingy with my mom. Like, I didn't know. So what the book shows you is, read the book, and kids are like, yo, I'm Dave. You know, like, they're identifying with the character. Like, why? Because I've been in schools all my life, so I know what they're going through. So what the assessment allows me to do is see and then put it in character. So they're like, yo, that that's me. I asked the question, yo, that's me. I'm angry, yo, that's me. You know, I don't have a lot of confidence. And so then after you read it and identify, you take the test. And once you take the test, you're like, bam, that's who I am.
Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and comment for more content.